My wife cheated and got pregnant. We want to reconcile and raise the child together. Title says it all. This is all still extremely fresh. The baby was born in August, and I was informed of the affair last weekend. I don't feel the need to go into all the details of the situation, but will provide an edit with a complete story if necessary. My instinct was to separate myself from everyone involved. She left my home and all of her things were moved out. I made plans for divorce and to sell my home. That was the first 3 days after I was told of the affair. Since then I've had time to think and talk with my wife. Speak to counselors and search my soul. She is remorseful and feared that I would reject any attempt to reconcile. She takes full responsibility and has made it clear that she is willing to go to any length to repair what we had. I still feel a strong bond to the child. For the entire pregnancy, I was led to believe that the baby is mine. After birth, it started to become obvious that the baby doesn't share any of my physical traits. I was beginning to get suspicious when I was finally told. None of that changes how I feel about my child. Unfortunately, due to the rapid reactions, it will take her time to fully separate. The affair partner is manipulative and controlling. He also claims to want custody. I am waiting to hear from my lawyer about my decision to reconcile. I feel like I'm rambling on. So I'll get to the point. What do I do? Edit. Thank you all so much for your responses. Obviously, this is a bad situation. I will be meeting with my counselor today, and I'm hoping to gain some more perspective. Her lies and the magnitude of this situation are not lost on me. And yes, it is possible that she is manipulating my emotions. It sounds to me like my desire to put my family back together is misguided. Some answers to recurring questions. Why even post about something so obvious? I'm lost. I need some validation that what I want to do could work out. However, the consensus is that it would not. Why come here if you already made a decision? The only decisions that have been made so far distance myself from the situation, protect me, and give me time. The most recent decision was to take time to figure things out and understand my options. This post is representative of my indecision to reconcile and raise the child. What I want does not mean I have made a decision. Why would you choose to reconcile? You have everything to lose and nothing to gain. I'm sure some of you can understand and maybe relate to the fact that I loved my life. I loved the image of our future. Now it has been ruined, but I still want what I had. By reaching out to an experienced community, I'm gaining knowledge I would have only gained with experience. Did you get a paternity test? Yes. I will have the results this week. My 27, wife 26, had a year-long affair that I discovered. Trying to reconcile with me, I'm still undecided. Hello all. This might be quite long. I'm posting this from my friend's place, where I'll be for a few days at least before going to a hotel for a while. Unfortunately, I discovered that this sub exists after having something done to me that I never thought in a million years would ever happen. My wife of 3 years has been having an affair for a year with a colleague of hers. I know him personally. I found out through her Gmail account on her laptop, which was left logged in. I had zero intention of checking her email, I just saw it there, and the text caught my eye. After this, I checked her phone and confirmed everything. I'm not going to lie, this kind of blindsided me. We have, or I guess had, a good relationship. We were regularly intimate, never really got angry at each other. We met in college and dated for almost 2 years before getting married. We were thinking of having kids in a year or two now that I have a good-paying job and have been progressing in my career. I actually wasn't suspicious at all. She's intelligent and clearly did well to cover her tracks. She never came home late at night, or acted distant/cold with me, or not been intimate with me. Not once did she tell me she was feeling unsatisfied or unhappy in our relationship. I had no idea anything was wrong at all, or I would have tried to fix it. Through her texts/emails, I saw that they usually got together during their lunch breaks, or they leave work early and go to a hotel/motel. The other guy isn't married, but he does have a long-term girlfriend. Haven't told her yet, haven't spoken to the other guy either. I took the day off work yesterday, left a note on the table for my wife, and I left for my friend's place. I told him everything. Sure enough, when she got home, she called/texted several times. I didn't answer at first, but I did eventually, and she immediately started crying hysterically and pleading me for forgiveness, saying it was a stupid mistake, and she will do anything to reconcile. We talked for a while, but I didn't really say anything of substance, and I haven't yet decided what I'm going to do. I'm not going to lie, I love her, but I can't stand betrayal of any kind, and this is up there. The thing is, when I was 18, I fell into a very dark depression, and it was the hardest thing in the world to pull myself out of. Took me 3 years, the only thing that helped was exercise/boxing. And now I feel myself slipping back in that hole. And as much as I love her, I also feel an intense hatred for her and the other guy. I'm debating confronting the other guy and badly hurting him, but my friend has insisted that I don't. I know my emotions are controlling me right now, which is why I wanted to be away from my wife and our apartment for a while so I can allow logic to at least get a foothold in my brain. I know if I see her crying, I'll start to feel sympathy for her, which I don't want to. Right now, my logical part says to divorce her, but I'm not 100% sure yet. I have thought about if I'll ever trust her again, and I think the answer is no. Here's the thing, I consider myself to be a fair person, and I always try to see both sides of the coin. I was looking around forums of infidelity, and I came across r/adultery. I thought it would be similar to this sub, quickly found out it was the opposite. However, I read through a few posts, hoping I could try and understand my wife's reasoning. Most of the posts were about the thrill of something new, the sexual satisfaction, trying to escape the unhappiness in their marriage, etc. The thing is, I'm not just saying this, I can't see how we had any of those problems. My wife was always intelligent and mature, which is why no matter how hard I try, I can't understand this. She repeatedly told me over the phone that it meant nothing, and she regrets it more than anything. But then, why do it? I asked her why and she just kept saying she doesn't know, and it was a lapse in judgment, etc. A year-long lapse in judgment? I'm questioning everything now, wondering if I've wasted years for nothing. Wondering if I'll ever trust another woman again. At the moment, I can't see myself ever being in a relationship again. I'm not naive enough to think people are infallible. But what's the point of committing yourself to someone if you're just going to find someone else? Anyway, that's it. I had to let all this out somewhere, even online. Not sure yet what my next step is, but at the moment, I can't see the marriage lasting. Her mother, whom I really like, has called me thrice, but I haven't answered. I haven't told anyone about it except my close friend that I'm staying with. I do have screenshots of the emails/texts between them as proof in case I need it. Short version, wife had a year-long affair, I found out through email/texts. Left a letter for her telling her everything, then left to stay with a friend. I haven't seen her yet. She is hysterical and pleading me to stay together and fix things. It's still too early for me to make a rational choice. I guess I'm just looking for input/advice from older/experienced people. Edit. Thanks for all your comments and time, everyone. I really do appreciate it a lot. Few things that have come up repeatedly. I have decided not to fight the other guy. It was just my emotions getting the best of me at the time. I will be getting an STD test and telling her to do the same. No compromise there. At the moment, I am leaning towards separating because I can't see how I will ever look at her the same way again. I still need some time to think, and will have to have a long talk with her. Her mother has since messaged me asking to please call her. She is a very good person and was very motherly throughout my time knowing her, so I will be calling her to talk to her soon, before I talk to my wife. Really, thanks to all of you. I actually hate that there are so many comments because that means so many of you men and women had this happen to you. Posting this here and telling my story is helping me release it all, and I will give you all an update when there is one. Quick update. So yesterday I went for a long walk and called back my mother-in-law. I didn't go into details, but I did mention that her daughter was seeing someone else behind my back for an extended period of time. She was understandably very upset and thankfully didn't try to force my hand into staying with my wife. We talked for a while and she asked me to give my wife a call, but I said I'll only do so when I'm ready to talk. I was walking over a bridge on my way back to my friend's place, and I'm not going to lie, for a split second I thought of jumping off. Told myself it would make things a lot easier. I let go of that thought immediately and kind of laughed. It's crazy what our minds can come up with. Anyway, I think either tonight or tomorrow night I will sit down with my wife and talk. I'm afraid my mind is 99% made up that I'll be asking for divorce, as I haven't been able to see any outcome where I won't be resentful towards her if we stay together. I will let her tell me everything she feels she has to say, and then will tell her my decision. I will post an update after we talk, I guess, depending. My wife had an affair, now wants to reconcile. How do we make things work? My wife had an affair. It started last April and lasted until November. She said she had sex with the guy in question on two occasions, late October and early November. We've been married since 2005, together since 2003. We're in our mid-30s and we have two kids together. A 4 and 6 year old right now, they're the only thing keeping us together. I first noticed a problem in June. She was talking to an old boyfriend who'd just broken up with his wife. Obviously, there were some unresolved feelings between the two. I started feeling uncomfortable in June, but when I brought it up with the wife, she always said it was nothing. In July, she visited him a couple of times, but she assured me nothing was happening. I started getting suspicious and snooped through her email, finding a couple of emails where he told her what he wanted to do to her. I confronted her about them, and she said it was one-sided and she had admonished him. I asked her to stop talking to him, but she insisted nothing was going on, and then got mad at me for telling her what to do. She had a lower sex drive than I did, but suddenly over the summer she was insatiable. Sensing something was off, we started going to therapy together. The therapist told us that she was getting attention that I haven't been giving her, and she was flattered. The solution, our therapist said, was for me to start giving my wife that attention. So I did. I'd ask about her day, I'd give her more compliments, and I tried giving her more space. I'd always had the kids a lot. I love spending time with them, and I knew that she had a hard time with them, so I took them a lot out to the movies, to play dates, kept them at home so my wife could go to conferences. Things didn't get better, The guy she was talking to doesn't have anything to do but talk to my wife, so he'd spend hours a day texting, writing emails and chatting. I was at a disadvantage because I have a job. For the month of July and August, I checked our phone bill and she had sent 8,000 texts each month. She was always on her phone. I got more and more frustrated and helpless, and that came out in the form of anger. We had fights nearly daily. Most of them were about her talking to this douchebag. I snooped more and more, looking at her email and text messages. She deleted chat logs and used passwords I didn't know to lock her Skype account. By the time September came around, we weren't having sex at all. She said she thought it was unfair that this guy was flattering her and she was having sex with me. She knew something was off. I asked her if sex with me was cheating on this other guy and she got mad at me. Our therapist told us to take a break for 1 week each time away from the family and kids. When we returned, nothing had changed and we were drifting further and further apart. I told her that I considered what she was doing an affair, and by continuing down that road she was breaking our marriage. But still the affair continued. October and November were hell. My contract with work was up for renewal, and I was scared that the distractions were affecting my work performance. I felt like I went through a breakup. My wife was gone, off with some other guy. In November, she admitted to having phone sex and video sex with him. I left and spent a week at my best friend's house. I remember the two times she cheated. The first time she went to a conference a day early. I brought the family to see her, and I could sense something was off. I didn't want to talk to her or look her in the eye. She insisted on a hug, and I felt dirty. The second was about 2 weeks later. I went to a conference, and she went to visit him. We had sex a few weeks after that, and I could barely maintain an erection. I felt like he was there. I was inside my wife, but he was somehow between us. I told her I felt this way, and she didn't say much. She only admitted to cheating a few weeks ago. The guy had come on the day she went early. I left the house and told her things were over. I was away early December for a work trip. I went a few days early to check out the city and get my mind off my problems. I ended up hooking up with two girls on separate occasions. I told women who asked if I was married that my wife cheated and I was single. Yes, technically I cheated without knowing my wife did, but shit was fucked up, you know. When my wife told me that things got physical between her and the douchebag, I told her about my trip. We went to therapy together, and she told us to take a month or two off. My wife told my therapist that she loves me and wants to work it out, and that she was sorry for how things went down. My friend visited this weekend and said that my wife seems really sad. I'm conflicted, to say the least. If there weren't kids, I would have bailed a while ago. Our therapist said that we both brought baggage to the relationship and we should try to fix the problem. We would only repeat our mistakes with the next person if we didn't. She wasn't advocating against breaking up, just fixing the issue. So, with that in mind, I worked at our issues, but I don't know how to get over this. It feels too big of a problem to deal with. She assures me things are over with that idiot and she wants me to come home. The night I left, I had a friend pick me up. He told me to go out and hook up with some girls, so I made an OkCupid profile. I had a whole bunch of girls contact me, and I've set up a few dates. The first is this Wednesday. The girls I'm meeting all seem really cool. They own their own businesses. They've accomplished something in life on their own. They're all super attractive to me. I feel attractive and desired for the first time in a long time. I feel like I'm in high demand and I'm loving it. When faced with the choice of dating a bunch of girls and my cheating wife, the decision doesn't seem very difficult. I know it sounds like I should move on, but I'm an introvert and tend to overanalyze. If I were to have another go with the wife, how do you move on from something like this? I'd sure as hell miss seeing my kids grow up half the time. Do I love my wife? I'm not sure. I feel a lot of hurt and betrayal. It's hard to look at her with loving warmth. The therapist is telling us to take time apart to give ourselves a chance to heal and see if we still love each other after the hurt has passed. I can feel that my wife is making an effort, but it might be too little too late.
Subscribe to my channel.